Hi, welcome to the presentation on the module 4 torsion. In this series, this is lecture number 9. In the previous lecture, we studied some important application based problem on designing the torsion, that is designing or finding the diameter of the shaft subjected to the twisting moment or torsion. Let us consider some more important problems here. A 150 mm diameter solid shaft, steel shaft, transmits 450 kilowatts, running at 90 rpm. Find the maximum shear stress. Also find the change in shear stress if the speed is increased to 360 rpm. So in this problem, there are two parts. In the first part, the shaft is running at 90 rpm. And while running at 90 rpm, it transmits 450 kilowatts at 90 rpm. So what is the shear stress in the shaft? This is the first part of the question. In the second part, if the speed is increased to 360 rpm from 90, what is the change in the shear stress due to this increased speed? So first, let us write the given data. Diameter of the shaft 150 mm, given power 450 kilowatts, power transmitted, and then speed running at speed 90 rpm. What is the maximum shear stress? First part of the question. In the second part, if the speed is increased from 90 to 360 rpm, what will be the change in the shear stress? So this we have taken tau dash maximum. So the other one we have taken tau max. So first let us find the shear stress, maximum shear stress in case of the shaft running at 90 rpm. So first we need to find the torque to find the shear stress by using the power transmitted equation, which is given here. Power transmitted is given by 2 pi nt by 60 watts, where n is the speed and torque, t is the torque in Newton meters. So let us find the torque first. Torque is equal to P into 60 by 2 pi n, and power 450, it is in kilowatts. So let us convert into watts by multiplying by 10 to the power of 3. So P into 60, 450 into 10 to the power of 3 into 60 divided by 2 pi, and speed is 90 rpm. So by solving this, we'll get the torque as 47746.5 Newton meters. So always remember, the torque that you get from this equation will be in Newton meters. But since the values of stresses are in Newton per mm square, so let us convert this torque into Newton millimeters. So multiplying by 10 to the power of 3, so the torque transmitted is 47746.5 into 10 to the power of 3 Newton millimeters. Using this torque, we can find the maximum shear stress using torsion equation. T by J is equal to tau by R. This is the first part of the torsion equation. Now, in this, if I substitute J, pi by 32, D fourth for solid shaft, and R is equal to D by 2, by solving the equation, we'll get torque is equal to pi by 16 into tau into d cube. Okay, this we get after substituting the value of J, substituting the value of R, d by 2. So 1 d is cancelled and 32 becomes 16. So torque transmitted through a solid shaft can be found out by pi by 16 tau into d cube, where tau is the shear stress. D is the diameter of the shaft. Now let us substitute this maximum torque that we have found out here. And from this equation, if I substitute diameter, which is given as 150 diameter, mm, I will get the shear stress as 72 Newton per mm square. So the interesting fact that we would like to know is, due to the increase in speed from 90 to 360, whether the shear stress increases or decreases, that we can find out by taking the again the power equation 2 pi. Now we'll take the speed as n1, 2 pi n1 t by 60 power 450 to 10 to the power of 3. So the speed now from 90 rpm to 360, there is increase in speed here. We have taken that. So substituting torque 2 pi n t by 60, and then we'll get the value of torque. This is the new value of torque, because due to the change in speed, the torque applied also changes. Again, this value is also in Newton meters. Let us convert it into Newton millimeters by multiplying by 10 to the power of 3. So in the torsion equation, again, if we take this value and substitute the value of J, pi by 32 d fourth and R d by 2, we'll arrive at this equation. This we already done. T is equal to pi by 16 tau d cube. Now substituting the value of this torque 11936.6 into 10 to the power of 3, pi by 16, we'll get a new shear stress value. D is 150, so which is 118 Newton per mm square. So at the shaft running at 90 rpm induces a shear stress of 72 Newton per mm square. That is the first case. And when the speed is increased to 360 rpm, the induced shear stress is 18 Newton per mm square. So that means there is a decrease in shear stress with the increase in the speed of the shaft. So that is the one important observation or conclusion that we can make in this problem. Coming to the next problem. So this is more or like a derivation here. Prove that a hollow shaft is stronger and stiffer than the solid shaft of same material length and weight. Now this is an important problem, because so when in most of the applications, we see that the solid shaft is replaced by hollow shaft, which saves the material also. And also it is given that the shaft is stronger and stiffer than the solid shaft. So in this problem, he's asking, prove that hollow shaft is stronger and stiffer than a given solid shaft, provided that both are made up of same material of same length and weight. So now we can see here, this is first one is in the figure, we can see one solid shaft of length LS and diameter DS, diameter of the solid shaft. There is only one diameter in case of solid shaft. Whereas in case of hollow shaft, we have two diameters. You can see DH, outside diameter of the hollow shaft, small DH, inside diameter of the hollow shaft. LH is the length of the hollow shaft. So length being same, you can observe. And then the material is also same. When material is same, the modulus of rigidity is same. So now let us assume some terminology here. LH is length of the hollow shaft. LS is length of solid shaft. WH is weight of hollow shaft. And WS is weight of solid shaft. So these are the length and weight, which are same for the both the shafts. Now, since material for the shaft is same, modulus of rigidity is same, and shear stress induced is also same. And diameters, outside and inside diameters for hollow shaft and diameter of the solid shaft. So now we know that specific weight is defined as the ratio of weight by volume. So if we take weight is equal to specific weight into volume from this equation, cross multiplying specific weight into volume, our volume is area into length. So weight of the shaft can be expressed as specific weight into volume, area into length. So first let us take weight of the solid shaft. Now it is given weight of the solid shaft is equal to weight of the hollow shaft. Writing the equations. So weight of solid shaft is specific weight of solid shaft into volume, that is AS into LS, area into length. Similarly for hollow shaft, specific weight of hollow shaft into area into length. Substituting area, pi by 4 dA square, LS. Observe here, for hollow shaft, the equation of area changes, pi by 4 dh square minus dh square. So from this, the terms that get cancelled here, because weights are same, and then material is same, specific weight is same, pi by 4 is cancelled. What remains? Length is also same. What remains is ds square, diameter of the solid shaft square, is equal to diameter of the hollow shaft square minus outside diameter square minus inside diameter square. So next, taking common here, the first term common, if I take dh square common here, inside I'm left with 1 minus small dh square by capital dh square. So if we take the ratio of small dh by capital dh, that is inside diameter of the hollow shaft by outside diameter of hollow shaft is k, and if I substitute here, now this equation becomes ds square is equal to dh square into 1 minus k square, and ds is equal to, taking the square root, dh into one root of 1 minus k square. So this is the relation we get, the relation that gives relation between solid shaft, diameter of the solid shaft and diameter of the hollow shaft, where k is ratio of inside diameter of the hollow shaft divided by outside diameter of the hollow shaft. Now once we get this, we can go for comparison. So we need to compare based on the strength and based on rigidity. We have to prove that hollow shaft is stronger and stiffer than solid shaft. So first let us take comparison based on the torsional strength. Okay, so let us use the torsion equation T by tau is equal to J by R, first part of the equation. So we know that the torsional strength is the ratio of torque to shear stress. So this torque to shear stress is equal to J by R. So torque to shear stress, that is this J by R for hollow shaft and J by R for solid shaft. If I take the right hand side part, J by R for hollow shaft, J by R for solid shaft. So we know that the polar moment of inertia is pi by 32 dh4 minus dh4, and R value is divided by, because we have divided by R here, R is dh by 2. Similarly for solid shaft, pi by 32 ds4. So you can make the difference here, hollow shaft two diameters, solid shaft only one diameter, divided by ds by 2. So terms gets cancelled here. This pi by 32 is cancelled. So the remaining terms are capital DH4 minus small DH4 divided by capital DH divided by DS cube, diameter of the solid shaft. And then rearranging the equation, we'll get DH to the power 4. If I take common again, divided by DH from the denominator, 1 minus small DH4 divided by capital DH4. So one dh gets cancelled here. So remains dh cube 1 minus k4, because we know that small dh by capital dh is k, k to the power 4. So ds cube, diameter of the solid shaft cube. So again, from this, already we have proved that from this equation, ds is equal to dh into square root of 1 minus k square. So in place of ds cube, I am substituting this whole to the power cube, so that becomes dh cube, and 1 minus k square, square root, that is 1 by 2 goes above, so 1 by 2 to the power 3, that is 3 by 2. So what we'll get is 1, so this dh cube gets cancelled here, and what remains is 1 minus k fourth divided by 1 minus k square to the power 3 by 2. So 1 minus k 4 can be written as 1 minus k square to the power square 2, and 1 minus k square we can take common into square root of 1 minus k square, and a square minus b square formula, 1 minus k square into 1 plus k square divided by 1 minus k square into square root of 1 minus k square. So this term gets cancelled here, and what remains is 1 plus k square divided by square root of 1 minus k square. So that means this ratio, that is t by tau for hollow shaft by t by tau for solid shaft is equal to 1 plus k square by square root of 1 minus k square. So we can clearly make out from this equation that, so this value will be always greater than 1 because in the denominator we have square root. So this value will be lower than this value. Hence, whatever the answer that we get will be always greater than 1. So that means for hollow shaft, the torsional strength is greater than that of solid shaft. So this proves that the hollow shaft is stronger than solid shaft since the ratio is greater than 1. If the ratio is less than 1, then the other way we can say. So as the ratio is greater than 1, the denominator is smaller. So if you take that term right side, it proves that hollow shaft is stronger than the solid shaft. So we are left with the second one, that is comparison based on torsional strength. We need to prove that the hollow shaft is more stiffer than the solid shaft. For that, we'll take the ratio from torsion equation. So torsion stiffness is defined as the ratio of torque by theta. So torque by theta, angle of twist for hollow shaft divided by solid shaft is equal to G into J by L. That is, this is from torsion equation for hollow shaft and G into J by L for solid shaft. So since the material is same and the lengths are same, these terms gets cancelled. So what remains is JH by JS, polar moment of inertia for hollow shaft divided by polar moment of inertia for solid shaft. Substituting for hollow shaft, pi by 32 DH4 minus DH4. For solid shaft, pi by 32 into DS4th. So from this, pi by 32 gets cancelled here. What remains is DH4 minus DH4 by DS4. So again, taking common this term, DH4. So if I take DH4 common, 1 minus DH4 by DH4. So this ratio is nothing but K. Small dh by capital DH is K. So 1 minus K4 by DS4th. So this DH4, again, DS square can be written as DS fourth can be written as DS square into DS square. Again, we have DS is equal to DH into square root of 1 minus K square. Already we have proved. So substituting this value and writing for 1 minus K4 as 1 minus K square into 1 plus K square, A square minus B square formula. So these terms gets cancelled. And again, what remains is 1 plus K square by 1 minus K square. Again, you can see that at the bottom, there is a difference, minus. And at the top, it is plus. So again, this ratio for hollow shaft and solid shaft is greater than 1. Again, this proves that hollow shaft is stiffer than solid shaft. So that proves that the hollow shaft is stronger and stiffer than solid shaft. Coming to one more important problem come derivation is, you need to compare the solid shaft and the hollow shaft for their weights if their lengths are equal. So now, in this case, it is given that their weights and lengths are equal and inside diameter is 0.6 times. Inside diameter of the hollow shaft is 0.6 times outside diameter. Okay. And both the shafts are made of the same material. So again, there are two shafts here. One is solid shaft and there is hollow shaft. Both are having same weights and lengths. And for hollow shaft, inside dia is 0.6 times outside dia. Okay, we need to compare the weights. So let us take DS is equal to diameter of the shaft. DH is the outside diameter of the hollow shaft, capital DH. Small DH is inside diameter of the hollow shaft. WS is weight of the solid shaft and WH is weight of the hollow shaft. and small dh is 0.6 times capital H. So we need to compare the weights of the hollow shaft and solid shaft in this case. So let us consider the torque transmitted equation. Torque transmitted by solid shaft is given by pi by 16 tau into ds cube. And for hollow shaft, it is pi by 16 into tau dh4 minus dh4 divided by capital dh. So now here in this equation, if I take dh4 common, so this ratio will become 1 minus small dh by capital dh to the whole power 4. And 1 dh is cancelled here. And in place of dh by dh, we can substitute the value, that is 0.6 here, 0.6 which is given. So 1 minus 0.6 to the power 4. So th is equal to pi by 16 tau 0.87 dh cube. So we have two equations here. One is for torque for solid shaft and torque for the hollow shaft. So equating one and two, because torque transmitted is same, pi by 16 tau ds cube is equal to pi by 16 tau 0.87 dh cube. So we'll get a relation here. Ds is equal to diameter of the solid shaft is 0.9 times diameter of the hollow shaft. So now taking the weights, the ratio of weight of the hollow shaft by weight of the solid shaft is equal to area of hollow shaft divided by area of the solid shaft. So pi by 4 dh square minus dh square by pi by 4 dh square. So pi by 4 gets cancelled and we have diameter square for hollow and solid shaft ratio. So from this, if I substitute for ds as 0.95 dh, in place of ds, if I substitute 0.95 dh, I will get the ratio as 0.70. That means the weight of the hollow shaft is 0.7 times weight of the hollow shafted solid shaft.